One thing that's going to help that I like to do, whatever arm's on top, that's what we're still looking for that arm, okay? If they're side by side here, guys, you still have to do this too. If you don't have arm that's on top, and you feel like, well, you're just fighting 50-50 here, okay? Cool thing about this is I'm just going to fight one, okay? I'm going to pick one, and I'm going to fight that arm, okay? Cool thing is I know if I fight this arm, one of two things is going to happen. He's either going to reach over and try to grab and fight, okay? Or he's going to put all his strength in that arm, and he's going to hold on real tight, okay? As he does that, if he puts all his strength in this arm, the other arm is going to get light, okay? So I'm going to start walking that up, and now I can switch off to the other arm, okay? So he looks like a pump fake too. I mean, if you go after one arm, they're usually going to put all their strength in this arm. They try to fight, switch the other hand real quick, okay? Go the other way, okay? But my favorite thing, we're going to stay low here, arm under the head, okay? Pretty much take this part of my forearm here. I'm going to come right inside of my hip here. I'm going to go right underneath the corner of his elbow, okay? I'm looking for right on the edge here. Whatever part of my arm I can get, okay? Whether it be here, anywhere along my arm, okay? So if he's here, he's hugging down, okay? Coming under. You'll notice I lean. Beware, when you lean, it might roll, okay? So be ready. So as we're here, I have this shoulder ready as well, okay? Or I can have this leg just ready to post, okay? But we gotta be ready for that roll, so be aware of that, okay? Because I'm gonna have to shift my weight. A lot of times if we're here and we're spurred on, I'm trying to do this thing to work, okay? He's just gonna out-muscle me. So I'm gonna have to come off to the side. I'll put that shoulder pressure in to where he has to turn that way. Now I'm gonna come under the shoulder. I'm gonna plant my hand on the ground. Pretty much make my hand like a spider, okay? I'm going to sit here. Go ahead and just resist a little, okay? And I'm just going to inch by inch. Just crawl. Just keep crawling towards his head. Just like that, okay? Take your time. You don't have to be in a hurry. Just wait for them to buck. Settle. Take your time here. You don't have to be in a hurry, okay? Once you get to this position and you're in here, just relax. Okay. They're going to be bucking like crazy trying to get out. Okay? So just try to weather the storm. Once they take a break, boom, then start working your stuff. Okay? Stay a little heavy. Boom. Just take your time. Walk that arm up. Okay? First thing, once this arm's up, a lot of people won't come and just do this. Okay? A hard time, sometimes I have a hard time because they'll just be putting counterforce through that arm, trying to make me not get my head there. Okay? So one thing that'll help is instead of trying to get our ear there, I'm just going to get my chin there. Okay? So once I'm here, chin comes right behind the elbow, and I just let my whole body slide down. Okay? And help you get to that arm front. So again, here, it's in tight, elbow. Walk that elbow all the way up. Boom. Chin. Slide. Sit back. My shoulder goes right underneath his chin. Okay? We're going to get off to the side. Finish. Okay? That's a full arm triangle. So we're going to cover that again next week. That's kind of what we're going to get to. But I'm going to get you guys used to just being able to stay in mount, not stay there. Okay? So stay nice and heavy. Dig those elbows. Okay? Cool. We're going to do this drill again. Yes.
What's the finish?
So the finish, this is called an arm triangle, which is the name of this submission. So the goal of this pretty much is anytime we're in mount, I don't want his elbows here, okay? So my whole goal is I gotta get these elbows up here. I want these elbows jacked up, okay? I don't want them down here, okay? So whatever it takes to get these arms up here is the best thing we can do, okay? Because as we do that, you also see my knees also act as, they're kind of, they help too. So I'm starting to move this up. I can start moving my legs up too. And start walking those arms up. Boom. So it is in here. Let me start looking for triangles. I got arm bars. Oh, sorry. The only problem you got over by here is let the little guys in bar too. Bam. They're going to bring their legs up. They're just going to invert. They're going to put their legs around you once you start getting up this high. So just be ready for that. Okay? But in here, you got arm bars. Start shooting stuff here. Okay? But the goal is to get the
this arm jacked up right here. One arm under the head. Walk this finger. Chin. Slide down. I'm going to set my weight. Everything's coming back. And I'm looking for underneath of this chin. Okay? So notice, once I get this chin, I'm sinking back. I'll use my hands to push myself down. And then I'm coming back. Okay? And I'm using my shoulders right here. Pretty much like a fist, just going straight up into your neck. Right underneath your chin. If you don't get over the chin, you're just going to crush the face. Sometimes they'll tap, but that sink back is what's going to help you. Okay? So once we're here, instead of just going straight down onto them, and coming over here, which we might use like a ton of muscle. Okay? I'm going to sit here. I'm going to sink back and use my hands. And I'm looking for underneath that chin. And then I can switch, and then I can start walking. Stay nice and heavy.
So when he sinks back, he gets himself low already. Mm-hmm. That way, he's not going to come up with the tension. He's going to slide.
It'll come under.
It'll come from under.
Just choke it out. Okay?
It's going to be a lot easier because all I know is anytime you get there, people are going to tuck your chin real hard so you can't get your shoulder under there because then you can't choke them. Okay? They'll just keep the pain. They'll be all right. So, when you sink back, though, it kind of pushes their chest down, and they can't quite get their chin all the way down, and you just get right underneath. That's when you choke them. Then your shoulder, all the pressure comes right through your shoulder. That's why when we're in that side control, practicing that shoulder against the jaw, it's the same kind of motion, okay, as when we're doing those arm triangles. Let that shoulder sink, okay? Just stay real heavy.
I'm gonna go get some more.